الناينث حديث قطعنا شوت. وعن معاوية بن أبي سفيان عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال في ليلة القدر. معاوية رضي الله تعالى عنه he said about the ليلة القدر, or when the ليلة القدر is going to be ليلة 27, that is going to be on the 27th night. رواه أبو داود والراجح وقفه, narrated by Abu Dawood, and he says the stronger opinion is that this narration is موقوف. What is موقوف again? وما أضفته إلى الأصحاب من قول وفعل فهو موقوف زكن. As the شاعر mentioned, any statement that the companion or his action, we say that this narration is موقوف. Can we say this is the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم? No. Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani rahimahullah ta'ala, he says at the bottom of this hadith, وَقَدْ اُخْتُلِفِ فِي تَعْيِينِهَا عَلَىٰ أَكْثَرَ مِنْ أَرْبَعِينَ قَوْلًا أَوْرَدْتُهَا فِي فَتْحِ الْبَارِ. The scholars, they differed over 40 views, and he mentions this in explanation of which kitab, Bukhari, called فَتْحُ الْبَارِ. 40 views of when Laylatul Qadr might be. And this issue, my brothers, you can split it into maybe three categories, all of these views. Some have absolutely no basis. It can't be whatsoever. Some have a level of truth to it. You see?
How can they have 40 views while Ramadan is 30 days?
Meaning of exactly when Laylatul Qadr might be. When Laylatul Qadr might be. So there's different views based on the hadith. You know, when they looked at it, they observed it, they... Are you with me, guys? Also, مِمَّا يُؤَيِّدُ أَثَرَ مُعَاوِيَةَ, that might strengthen the statement of Muawiyah, that Ubay ibn Ka'b رضي الله تعالى عنه قال, وَاللَّهِ, by Allah, إِنِّي لَأَعْلَمُ أَيَّ لَيْلَةٍ هِي, by Allah, I know when this night is going to be. هِيَ لَيْلَةُ الَّتِي أَمَرَنَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ بِقِيَامِهَا. It is the night in which the Messenger commanded us to stand up for the prayer. هي ليلة 27. It is what? 27th night. Hey, what should we do, guys? Should we just pack our bags for the last 10 nights? You know, just call it a day. Let's all just come and stand up on the 27th night.
And this course explained, is it just that year? He knew it for that year. But it changes up.
Laylatul Qadr, the scholars, they mentioned, my brothers, it moves from one night to another. Are you with me, guys? When you look at all the hadith, now let's stand over it. Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith, إِلْتَمِسُوا فِي الْعَشَ الْأَوَاخِرِ, one narration. Try and find in the last 10 days. There's another narration. إِلْتَمِسُوا فِي السَّبْعِ الْأَوَاخِرِ مِنَ الْعَشَ الْأَوَاخِرِ. Tamam? Try and search for it in the last 7 nights of the last 10 nights. Another narration, the Messenger of Allah said, إِلْتَمِسُوهَا فِي الْعَشْرِ الْأَوَاخِرِ فَمَنْ ضَعُفَ وَعَجِزْ. Whoever now becomes weak, or becomes, you know, tired, then don't let the last 7 nights slip away from him. السَّبْعَ الْبَوَاخِرِ, as the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned. فَلَا يُغْلَبَنَّ عَلَيْهِ السَّبْعُ الْأَوَاخِرِ. والسبع البواقي. And also Shaykh al-Islam Taymi rahimahullah, he said, ينبغي للمؤمن أن يتحرى ليلة القدر في جميع ليالي العشر. One should be smart by looking for ليلة القدر every single night of the last 10 nights. Because what are you going to do if the month now ends up what? Finishing one day early. And every night is gonna what? Fall back one. So brothers, you know, to get over all of this khilaf, one just works hard on every single night. You're done with Taraweeh, go home and pray. Spend your nights praying. And this is what Shaykh Sulaiman Rahili Hafidhullah Ta'ala advised with. One wants to now do the Taraweeh and likewise pray, pray your whole night. Because sometimes the question that gets posed is, which one is better? Shall I do Taraweeh or shall I do Qiyam? He says, do both of them. Time we should be burning ourselves out, right? And also you look at the hadith of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, Ubay bin Samit radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, خَرَجْتُ لِأُخْبِرُكُمْ بِلَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. I one time left my house in order to tell you about Laylat al-Qadr. The Messenger knew when he was going to be. فَرُفِعَتْ فَتَلَاحَ فُلَانُ وَفُلَانُ فَرُفِعَتْ. So when the Messenger came out, he saw two people, they were arguing, they were disputing. And then the Messenger forgot it. He said, فَعَسَىٰ أَنْ يَكُونَ خَيْرًا لَكُمْ. Perhaps this is better for you. And then what did he say? فَالْتَمِيسُوا فِي التَّاسِعَةِ وَالسَّابِعَةِ وَالْخَامِسَةِ. If you really want Laylatul Qadr, try and find on the 29th, the 27th, or the 25th. Other narrations, 23, 25, 27, 29, right? Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never specified it. And what is the hikmah behind this? Imagine guys, I ask you, billah alayk, we don't even know when Laylatul Qadr is going to be today, in this day and age. Do we know? Can somebody say one of it's going to be 27?
No.
Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying it has been forgotten. He himself didn't know. We find that the 27th night, the masajid are packed. And we don't even know. Imagine if we did know. Do you think the people are going to come on the 23rd, the 22nd, the 21st? The place is going to be empty. Let's all just wait for the 27th or the 23rd. Are you with me, guys? So that's the hikmah behind it. أَنَّ الْإِنسَانِ يَجْتَهِدْ. He works really, really hard throughout. And he tries to catch it. So if one does ibadah on every single last 10 nights, huh? Is he going to miss Laylatul Qadr? He's not. If you pay a pound for every single what? Day or night from the last 10 nights, how happens? Inshallah, you're going to get Laylatul Qadr. If you pray on every single night, most likely you're going to get it, right? So that's the best way out of the 40 different views that are out there. Some of them aqwal batila, as Ibn Hajar rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, that you can split it into three categories. Aqwal batila, aqwal da'ifa, some statements that are absolutely false. Some of these 40 is very weak. And some of the third category is aqwal rajihah.